13, Bloomin' Stephen, the younger and the old, had been through several foster families.
Nope.
38 all told. Mischief moved them on in life, and moving kept them close. For Bloom had Stephen and Stephen Bloom, and both had more than most. Another home, another Main Street. Stephen looked around and summed the burg up thusly.
Bloom, you've hit a one-hat town.
Could he simply
talk to her?
Just drop his fears and go? Leave his brother in the woods and join the children? No. So, in the root of Stephen's psyche, something now began. A seed of grand epiphany. A hook. A tale.
A plan.
A fiction, both for profit and to ease his brother's heart. A simple con in 15 steps.
And this is where we start.
And then, as if a curtain had been pulled back from the sky, some barrier within the younger Bloom was broken.
Hi.
So Bloom performed his role in Stephen's story to a T, and being who he wasn't, could be as he wished to be.
There's a hermit in the woods, a one-eyed steel-toothed vagabond.
With blood-red eyes?
That's good. He stopped you coming home from school.
And told me of a cave.
What kind of cave?
A cave of wonder.
Ha.
Shut up, Dave. At noon on every Sunday, there appears a ball of light, which flutters like a butterfly.
A will-o-wisp?
That's right. It guides you.
If. Can keep up.
To where the treasure's led.
So where's this cave?
Yeah, where?
Aha! The hermit didn't say.
He got this greedy, glinting look, the filthy red-eyed leech, and said he'd tell for 30 bucks. Well, that's just $2 each!
And so that Sunday, straight from church, into the woods, Bloom led. They stopped. Their hearts leapt. There it was.
Just like the hermit said.
For just one moment, Bloom forgot himself and ran too fast. He'd catch the light and find the treasure. But the moment passed.